大家好，我觉得我中文说的不很好，但是我要用英文，可以吗？
可以。
好的，好的。
慢一点点哦。
慢一点点。Okay. If I speak too fast, just let me know.
I will remind you. Okay.
Yes, because sometimes when I get passionate about something, I just go like a machine. So I speak very fast.And stuff like that. So if you think that you don't understand, then I need to slow down. Just let me know. Just show your hands. And I'm very happy to, you know, repeat it or go over it because I think, you know, the thing that I'm going to be talking about is really exciting. And because I've had a chance to look at the school, look at Accelerator, look at the people that are doing business here, I think what you're doing here is amazing. And I would love to support you as much as I can.So even afterwards, if you have any questions, or if you just want to talk to me, you can add me on WeChat, or we can chat one-on-one, because I would love to provide as much value as possible. So thank you very much for having me. I really appreciate it. I'm so excited. I always like to talk to students, because I think it's very important to talk to people like yourself, because you're full of ambition and energy, and now you need to, you know, transition that energy into something amazing.So, my name is Jan. I'm from Czech Republic. I've been in China for almost 3 years. I live in Shenzhen, and currently I work for a company which is called Startup Grind. I have the t-shirt, you can see it here. And what the company does, we are number one startup community in the world. We have people in 300 cities around the world. We connect startups with investors, mentors,We provide a lot of education to founders, to aspiring founders like yourselves. And we just want to build startup ecosystems and help you succeed in your businesses, in your adventures. So that's what I'm doing. I'm responsible for China and Asia in general as a region. And we currently have 50 cities in this region, and 12 of them are in China. And we are rapidly expanding, and I hope that we can maybe do something in Dongguan as well.Later that we can host events on a regular basis. I will have some examples of the events that we host so that you can see. Okay. How's the map? So why China for me, right? Because I'm not from China, I'm from Czech Republic, and I came to China almost 3 years ago now.And I came to China because I started a business at the university, actually.I was basically sitting in the same place 3 years ago, and you know, I was always eager to learn. I always wanted to do more than just studying books and writing homeworks. It was great. You know, I was a pretty good student, I would say, but I always wanted to learn more. And I figured that I can only learn more if I do it myself. I cannot really, it's great to read books, and it's great to listen to things, butIf you really want to learn, you need to start doing stuff. And I think that's what you're doing here, and I'm so excited to be here because I saw many students actually sitting in the office and trying to figure out how to make money on the internet and how to build a business. I think this is really amazing. And you know, the fact that school gives you this opportunity is really, really good. So you know, don't take it lightly. It's not happening everywhere. And so I started a business, and the business was actually,with China. So we were importing stuff from China. We were dealing with mobile phones, accessories, and some stuff. And we had an e-commerce website in Czech Republic and Slovakia. And we were selling those things, those products that we brought from China to customers in Slovakia and Czech Republic. And that was my first experience of running a business myself.And I was fortunate enough that the business was actually doing pretty well. We were able to grow pretty fast. We were able to make some money. And that's why I decided to move to China to explore if we can do something bigger. Because I never met my suppliers before. I was only chatting with them on WeChat and chatting with them on Skype and email, but it's not enough, right? So I wanted to go into China and learn even more about this market, about you,as customers and as people and culture. I just wanted to learn more again. So that's why I ended up in China. And so now it has been 3 years, and I'm not running the business anymore. I sold the share in the company to my co-founder because I wanted to do something that is bigger in terms of impact. I wanted to work with more people, and Startup Grind gave me this opportunity to do so. So that's why I'm working for this company right now. But I'm still entrepreneur at heart because I definitely want to get back to running my own business in the future. But I don't know what it's gonna be. I'm still learning, also in China, learning a lot of things, and we'll see what's gonna happen. So this lecture is supposed to be, or lecture, or this speech is supposed to be about entrepreneurship. And so I wanna give you my perspective, how I think about entrepreneurship. Because I can say that I've been an entrepreneur myself, now I work, but I am very entrepreneurial still. Even though I'm employed, I'm still very entrepreneurial, and I want to give you this example that it's not only about running your own company to be an entrepreneur. You can be an entrepreneur within the company. You know, you can become a CEO of a big company because you are an entrepreneur, because you are willing to work harder than others, and you're willing to build something bigger for others and make bigger impact. So for me, how I see entrepreneurship, this is something that I came up with. I don't know, I didn't find it on the internet, so I don't know if this is true or not. This is my thinking, how I see entrepreneurship. And so for me, it's really about the mindset, about the attitude that you have, the attitude that you want to work harder than others, that you don't just want to sit in a class, study, and then go home and play games and this, but you probably want to do something bigger and you want to build something. Maybe it's business, maybe it's just some project, maybe it's, you know, learning how to play piano, whatever. Just having the mindset that you always want to work on yourself and work on your skills and provide value to others, which is very important. So, you know, it's willingness or attitude to work hard and building something valuable for others. And I'm going to go through this real quick right now because I think it's important to mention a couple of things. So the first one, right? Willingness to work hard. I know that you hear it all the time, probably, you know, from your parents and from people around yourself, that you need to study hard, work hard, succeed and stuff like that. For me, this is not that. This is not to push you in that. It's about the attitude that, you know, if you ever want to be an entrepreneur or if you want to build something, if you want to become a successful person, it's just about that you really need to take one step forward, that you need to take action, you know, that it's not about it's going to come to you, but you need to see those opportunities. You need to go out there, you need to learn certain skills if you don't have them, or you need to find those skills that you have and that you can use and maybe turn into business. So this is the attitude. And it's very important, it starts there, because if you don't have this attitude, nothing can probably help you to build a business. Because you will always have to learn, you will always have to adapt, markets change all the time, so the fact that you start business today doesn't mean that the business is gonna be the same in 3 years. You always have to be able to navigate, which means a lot of work. So that's the first step. The second is, you need to build something, right? Because if you want to build a business, you probably want to sell something. So you can either sell a t-shirt, which we saw that one of your teams is selling t-shirts, right? So you can produce a t-shirt, or you can produce some customized t-shirt and you can sell. And so that's the product. That's something, you need to build something that you can sell to somebody. Or it doesn't have to be a product, right? Like a physical product. It can, for example, be that you're gonna build a community of people. You're gonna build something that is maybe not tangible in the sense that you can touch it, but maybe you can sell it as a service. So this is the next step. First, you need to have that attitude that you actually wanna do it, and then you need to build it, right? And the thing that you're building needs to have some value for other people. Because if it doesn't have the value, then probably you're not gonna build a business because people will not be willing to pay for that because it doesn't have value for them. The fact that it has value for you doesn't mean that it has value for other people. So you also need to keep this in mind that the thing that you're building is something that is very valuable for others, and then there is actually a lot of people willing to pay for something like that. Now, there is another question. The question is, should I start a business, right? Because the thing that I was talking about is the entrepreneurship and starting a business and building a product and stuff like that. But I want to get back to the first thing that I mentioned at the beginning, and that's that, you know, you actually don't need to be an entrepreneur by just starting a business. You know, maybe you can join somebody who started a business and you can do it together, and you can be co-founders and you're still entrepreneurs. Or you can be like number six employee of a big company, which is still gonna mean that you're an entrepreneur because you're probably gonna have some stake in the company, but you don't have to be the founder per se to become an entrepreneur. So this is the question that you should ask yourself, right? Like, should I start a business at the first place? And so my answer to this, or how I would approach it from your perspective, I would ask myself, do I have those three things that I was talking about? Do I have the attitude first, that I wanna work hard, that I don't mind that I'm gonna be, you know, going to bed a little bit late because I have some order to fulfill, or I have some project to finish and I really need to get it done. So do I have that attitude? Second, do I have the skill to build something, right? Because I need to build something or I need to create something. So you need to ask yourself, do I have that skill? If not, maybe you can find somebody that is gonna teach you how to build something, or you're gonna study yourself. You're gonna find some courses on the internet because there is a lot of knowledge on the internet these days. You can just read articles, you can read books, or you can talk to other people that are gonna help you to learn or get that skill. Or you can find teammates, right? You can find teammates, and we discussed that. You can find people that are gonna be part of the team, and everybody is gonna have a different skill, and all together it's gonna click and it's gonna create an awesome team that is gonna build a business. So there are these things that you need to be asking yourself. And the third thing, of course, if the thing that you build, if you have that team and if you have everything, if it's something valuable and if the market wants that kind of thing, or if you need to change it, if you need to like do some market research and validation and all these things, we can be talking about this for ages because there's definitely so many other things that come into play when building a business. But this is kind of just an overview how to think about business at the first place. And so, as I said, if you don't have one of those, maybe you have this and this, but you don't have this. Or maybe you have this because somebody told you that you are very good at something. Your teacher told you like you're very good at this, so you know you have a skill, but maybe you don't have the attitude to start your own business. So you need to be asking yourself these questions: what you have, what you don't have, and what is the thing that you need to do to get it. Yeah? So this is very important, and this is gonna help you to answer the question if you should start a business at the first place, or if you need to wait, or if you just need to join somebody and stuff like that. Of course, there are some risks as well, and I believe that when you're having some class, you talk about the risks, right? You talk about the competition, you talk about the market, and sometimes the market goes up, but sometimes it goes down, and that means that your business might actually go down as well. So there are some risks, inherent risks that are linked, that are connected to running a business. So you need to consider those as well. But my answer to this, because I had the same experience that I actually started my first business at the university as well, is that guys, you're the students, right? So if the company is not gonna work out, it's fine, because you know you're still at the university, you're very young, and you can do it all over again. You know, you can learn. And that's why I think that at your stage or at your age, you should definitely give it a try. Because there is nothing to lose, especially if you have this amazing environment that the university is building for you, that you can join the accelerator, you can maybe even talk to some mentors, you know, they can give you the skills and they can help you with administration and setting up the company and whatever it is. Like, if school provides this, then basically for you there is no downside, there is no like big risk. Because if it's not gonna work out, it's fine, because your life doesn't depend on that business, right? Because you're still a student. You can always go and get a job, or you can do something else. So my answer to this would be like, you should give it a try, as I did. And for me, it worked out. Of course, many times I tried different things, it didn't work out. We fail all the time with projects. You know, it doesn't matter, because it's just part of the journey. But if you have that attitude that you want to learn, and you consider the failure or whatever it is as a learning point, then that's amazing, and you should keep going. The second thing that is linked to should I start a business or what the business is gonna be is, and we also briefly discussed this when we were having dinner, is you should find your passion. Do you know what passion is? Do you know what it means? Teaching. Right? So,
sorry? Teaching is talent.
Huh?
I mean, the passion is teaching.
Okay, teaching. Okay. So, I think this is really, really important, because, you know, for me, it was kind of a passion to do something more, as I told you. I always wanted to learn and I wanted to explore. And so for me, it was kind of easy to start something, or of course it wasn't easy. I don't want to say it was easy, because we had a lot of troubles and problems with my co-founder. But we started, and because we had this passion that we wanted to be entrepreneurs. The same thing applies for my company right now. Because after I sold the share in the business, I knew that I am very passionate about helping other people, working with people, and building something that has impact. So for me, I was actually doing this. I was actually working for this company. I was volunteering. I was doing it for free for 1 year before I joined the company full time. Because I was passionate about hosting events, meeting new people, interacting with new people, learning new things. So for me, it was a passion. And so that's why I'm here, and I'm just so energetic and excited, because for me, this is really what drives me.
Thank you, friends.
So,
thanks for your passion.
So you should try to find something similar, you know? And I'm not saying that it's gonna be easy. Maybe you're not gonna find it right away, and you shouldn't be upset about it. Because it takes time. For me, it took a lot of time too. You need to try different things. You need to talk to a lot of people, and even get advice from your teachers and from your mentors, because they can see you from a different perspective, and they can tell you what you're good at, what you're enjoying doing when you're in class and whatever. So they can give you feedback on that. So you should start with that. You should start getting that feedback from other people and asking them how they see you. If they see you as a next soccer star, because you play soccer all the time and you're just the best. Or if they see you as a next engineer, because you're still coding every day and you're creating games and whatever, and maybe you don't see it because for you it's a hobby, and you don't see it as something that might be also practical, but maybe they can tell you, yeah, I've seen that guy that was doing the same thing and he made a lot of money, you should maybe try it too. So you should talk to as many people as possible and try different things so that you can find your passion. But it's a long process. It's a long process. And it's very directly linked to how to start. I told you these things about the feedback and talking to people, and I want to give you something even more practical. Because what we are doing, and what other companies are doing, and other organizations, and even your university here, they're creating different platforms for people like yourselves to find their passion, or to meet other people that can, you know, give them that feedback, and it can tell them that, yes, I want to work with you on this project, and you're great at this, and I'm great at that. So I want to give you something more practical. And so these are a couple of organizations that are pretty active in China as well. I don't know if you have, for example, have you heard about Startup Cell? Chuang Yixiao?
Last year, yes.
Yes. So this is a company that my friends in Shenzhen started, I think, I would be lying, but maybe four years ago, they started this company. And these two companies are very similar. And what they do is that they help people that are thinking about being entrepreneurs. They help them to meet other people that have different skills. They put them into one room for a weekend so that they can talk to each other, interact. They bring in mentors and people from companies to give them feedback on their ideas. And they can execute those ideas during the weekend. They can pitch it on the stage like this. They can pitch their idea. They can get another feedback. And basically, they can help you to either start a business, because maybe your idea is going to be very, very good. And somebody in the audience, maybe some investor even, they invite investors. Maybe some investor can give you money. Or you can win some prize, and you can take the business to the next level. So this is one of the examples. Mars Summit.
火星峰会.
Okay, so Mars Summit, it's a big conference. It's in Shenzhen. It's actually gonna happen in December this year. And it's a conference for maybe 5-10,000 people. And they have people from Silicon Valley, Europe, China, Singapore, Australia, from all around the world coming and educating people when it comes to investments, when it comes to starting a company, and all the other things. Plus, you can also submit your company. If you already have some startups here and you need help or you need to raise some capital, then you can submit your company to this conference. And if you're good enough compared to other companies, they can choose you and they can give you mentorship. They can give you opportunity to pitch in front of thousands of people to get feedback on your idea again. And that will help you figure out if this business is good for you, not good for you, is it viable business, not viable business, and stuff like that. Blackbox. We discussed that, right?
Yeah.
So Blackbox is also an amazing company. And they actually do events twice a year here in Dongguan. They bring people from Silicon Valley, they spend 1 week here, and they invite entrepreneurs to apply, and they give them mentorship. They teach them how to make their business even better. And then they have a competition. Maybe out of one or two out of 10 to 15 startups, they are invited to go to Silicon Valley for 2 weeks for free. They pay for everything. And you can go with them and you can experience what it's like to be in Silicon Valley. So that's amazing. And they come to China. They, unfortunately, you said that they didn't have time to come here, but who knows, maybe next time they're gonna come. But you should watch out for this competition. If you see it somewhere, just don't hesitate to apply or to attend that competition, because it will give you a lot of new ideas. I guess you know these two, right? Isaac and Actus, do you know? Hands up, no? Nobody? So these two organizations are also amazing. So these are student organizations. They're all around the world. They are huge organizations. And I know I have a lot of friends in ISEC China, and they're amazing. They host a lot of events. They help people like yourself to get internships, to get experience in companies, you know, help you interact with your peers and learn from each other. And Enactus is doing something similar also at the universities and colleges. And, you know, if there is no Enactus or Isaac here at this university, you can start it. You can apply, you can start this branch here, and you can start hosting events. You can maybe invite even some of them, you can join their conferences around China. And again, you will meet people that are like-minded, that want to do something extra, that want to learn, that will give you feedback, and maybe you will find somebody with whom you will build a business. So that's also amazing. Global Shapers, another amazing community. I have a lot of friends in Beijing, Hangzhou, Shanghai, Shenzhen. They all are part of this Global Shaper community. It's a community for young people. It's limited by age, so if you're over 35, you cannot join. It's only for youth, and they basically give them different projects to solve. So they can solve different projects, even for local companies, maybe even with the government. They also host a lot of events and conferences. Actually, this year, I am helping organize one conference in Hangzhou, and they are going to be, again, inviting a lot of people from all around the world, and they are going to be focusing on entrepreneurship, youth, innovation, and again, great community. This one, I guess you know, right? All China Youth Federation. Have you heard about it? That it's Chinese. It's Chinese. That's not outside of China. This is only in China. If you have never heard, I would recommend you to check it out. So this is the largest youth organization in China. I think their members, the number of members is like 400 million people. Because it covers people from 14 to 35 years old, again. And you know, there are different organizations that support entrepreneurs, youth innovation. You can join their events, you can join their programs, you can maybe get some grant even from them for your company and stuff like that. Last but not least, Halprise. This is the largest social entrepreneurship competition in the world. Every year they have a final in Shanghai. It's a regional final. If you have a business that is solving some big problem in a society, for example, poverty or education or helping people in slums to, you know, increase their income and stuff, you can apply and you can go to Shanghai to compete. And if you win, you can go to New York where they have amazing competition. My friend is actually running this company in China. And it's extraordinary what they are doing. So these are the communities that came to my mind today when I was thinking about what I'm going to be talking to you about. And I think I would encourage you to look these up. They are in China. They are very active in China, all of them, in different cities. Maybe not all of them are in Dongguan, but many of them are in Shenzhen, which is not so far away. And maybe you can even bring some of them to Dongguan. Which leads me to the second or maybe the last thing that I want to be mentioning, and it's when you ask me how to start. I told you that before I started working for this company, I volunteered for 1 year for this company. And I was helping this company, you know, to host events in Shenzhen, and we built an amazing community. And so if you are still not sure what you're passionate about, but you know that something drives you, that you want to do something more, that you maybe don't want to be just a participant at these events, maybe you can start some of those organizations yourself here in Dongguan, because they're always looking for people that are active, that are eager to do and build something for others. That comes down to my third thing that I was talking about, right? Build something for others that others will see value in, because it will give you amazing, huge amount of opportunities. Because you will meet your friends, new friends, people. Maybe you will get a job offer from an amazing company because they will see that you are not only, you know, studying or doing your business, but you're also building an amazing community where others can get other opportunities as well. So I would encourage you, if you maybe don't want to run a business, but you know you want to do something, check this out. Apply and maybe bring some of them here to Dongguan, to your university, or maybe to the city, and you will see that it's gonna be amazing. Startup grind. I just want to go through real quick because what we are doing is basically that's why I joined the company, because I think the impact is just incredible. And you can actually, I'm actually now here also because my idea is to bring our community here to Dongguan and to host events like this on a monthly basis, to bring successful entrepreneurs from China but also from all around the world and bring them here and host amazing events that you all can learn from. And so just really briefly what Startup Grind is. And I already told you that we are in 12 cities in China. Hopefully we can open in Dongguan very soon. We have worked with companies like these. These companies either spoke at our events or they attended our events. So as I said, doing something like this, being an entrepreneur, and just building something for others, not just a company, but maybe a community, can bring you amazing opportunities because you can meet people from these companies and maybe you can get a job in one of those companies or internship. And you can learn and afterwards you can start a business because you will have a lot of experience and you will meet other people that can help you connect the dots. And this is how our events look. I think this is Beijing. This is Beijing as well. This is Shenzhen. And this is Chengdu. Amazing events, full of people. We have Steve Hoffman, maybe you have heard about him. He is very popular in China right now because he published his book in Chinese. And he talks about startups, corporate innovation. And he is also kind of an inspirational speaker because he has a lot of experience working with founders and he can really push them into a different direction. So we invite people like this. Of course, we also invite local entrepreneurs, Chinese entrepreneurs, that can share the story in Chinese because maybe it's easier for you to comprehend and we really want to make that impact. So that's why we do both. We try to be very international, bring people from Silicon Valley or from Europe and other companies, but also local entrepreneurs that have amazing stories to share. So this is our events. This is our biggest event in China yet, in Hangzhou. We hosted this event last month and we had CEO of NetEase coming. We had really influential people coming to this event to share their stories and experience with the audience. We had around 400 people in the audience. It was amazing. And this is our director in Hangzhou. And he basically took that opportunity to run this community in Hangzhou and to build something for himself and for others, which for me is also an example of entrepreneurship. Because maybe he is working for somebody, but in his free time, he is doing and building something for others, which is gonna bring him many opportunities in the future. So everybody's journey is different, but if you really wanna work harder than the others, you have a lot of opportunities out there. And this is just values, but I think we don't have to spend time on that. And this is just the mission. Our mission is to build global entrepreneur hub that people from all around the world can meet each other, either offline like this or online. They can exchange ideas, they can learn from each other, and we can maybe even help them to expand their business. If their business in China is doing very well and they want to expand overseas, we can connect them with our local hubs and help them to succeed. So this is what we're doing. And I think that's all for me, and I would love to get some questions if you have some. Thank you.